dances some more.
How did you get involved in it?
Well, I watched the Rufus and Margot Rose, who lived over in Connecticut, and I worked with them, and they were doing Howdy Doody and things like that, and that's how I got started. And I worked with them on the Christmas Carol and everything. They were the first puppet things I ever saw, and I saw them out in high school or grade school in Indiana, and I thought, oh, if I could ever work with that company. It takes about 25 of these to make a show, and these are discs that fit into a slot so that I can take them up and put them in a slot and leave them, and I can reach over and just touch like this if they're talking to each other. So I can get three or four of them are going all at the same time. They're all plastic wood. You'll notice that some of the pieces of plastic wood have holes in them. And that's because plastic wood, if you don't do that and it's thick, the plastic wood hardens on the outside and stays soft on the inside. So I poke holes in it so that the whole thing will get hard in the same time, same way.
Cinderella, after you finish dusting, do the dishes, cut the grass, and carry out the garbage. By that time, your sister and I will be back from a hat store.
This is the only one, a puppet that has any motion at all. And she gets in an argument with her sister, and her sister says something bad to her. So she turns to the audience and sticks her tongue out. That's the only action in the whole show like that.
You were well into your career and you were an adult before you started writing the shows, the puppet shows and performing.
Yeah, I worked for other companies around.
I worked for other puppet theaters?
Yes, I started really. My first job was a Good Teeth Council for Children out of Chicago, and I worked for them for a couple of years.
Just remember, Cinderella. It's better to have loved and lost than never to have lived in a glass house. Sister. That's wrong. It should be. Shut up! Your sister and I are going to the hat store now. We'll be the best looking girls at the ball. Come on.
Let's go. She goes out.
The transition from doing these other jobs and doing puppetry whenever you could to being such a well-known and highly respected puppeteer, doing your
Yeah.
performances all over the world. How did, and you say you were never able to sell anything. Somebody must have
Oh
seen
yeah.
your
A lot
work.
of a lot of them would be government things that they would invite me over to do and look after me and take care of.
Like Russia and Prague, I think.
Oh
Do
yes,
you know
I
any
played all. I played all
Czechoslovakia?
those European countries.
Yeah, but did someone happen to see one of your
The word
works?
got around when I first went over there and played Moscow and places like that.
Ah.
That this American is worth watching. They paid my way, but what? I didn't make any money on it, but I thought, boy, people back home, they'll really flock to see me when I get back. I
Uh-huh.
just played with Moscow, but it means nothing at all.
You were living in Woodstock a while too. It was about
Yes, when I built Cinderella here, and it didn't sell well at all because I have no ability to sell anything, and so I thought, well, maybe I'll learn how to fly. And so I put an ad in the New York Times and got that job that I just goofed on with the silver, and I moved to Boston. I got the job of photographing at night one of the first missiles that ever went out into outer space and came back, and we recovered it. And so they brought it into Boston, and I set my cameras up, and 35 and 16, and I wasn't happy with the lights. I had big lights down to photograph this thing that had been brought in from outer space.
Uh-huh.
So I looked around for a piece of paper or something or other, and I found just the right shade, the right everything. So I sat it down on one of the workbenches there, and I photographed it on this little piece of paper, and went home and slept well. And when I came back in the morning, people were buzzing. Did you hear? Did you know that blah? And I said, what's going on here? They found that they sent this missile out into outer space, and when it came back, it had silver on it. Silver, and the people were... I said, oh my God, I did it again.
Oh,
this
no.
is my fault. Because what I did was, the paper I picked up was photography paper, which is filled with silver. I put it down, and the heat from those lamps impregnated
oh,
the
no.
thing. And I had to go into the head boss and say, sorry, didn't.
Right, don't get too excited.
Yeah,
about,
all right.
Minerals.
So I started with nothing and worked my way through all the different pilot exams and tests. And then before I left this part of the country, I got my mechanics license too. And that took another 2 years. And then I decided to go to California and open a little airport. And so I had this little airplane. But
uh-huh.
when I landed at each little airport, they'd say, I'd say, I want to open up this or buy land or something. I didn't have any money, but.
Uh-huh.
And they'd say, look, land is so valuable out here, I can sell this little bit of land and retire for the rest of my life. And so nothing worked out, so I flew this little airplane all the way back.
You wanted to see me, Prince? Yes, Counselor. I would like to know how the plans are coming along for the ball. Has everyone in the kingdom been invited? Yes, Prince, everyone that we know of.
Oh, dummy.
And don't forget, Prince, that you are to dance with the most beautiful girl at the ball. Oh, I won't forget. That's fun.
And
also, Prince, remember that you're a grown man now, and you must soon be getting married. So be sure and look at all the girls at the ball. I will. And the entertainment. How's the entertainment coming?
That tended.
It just so happens, Prince, that I'm going to audition several people right now. Would you like to watch? Yes, I would. Very well. The first will be an acrobat who will perform for us. Going to be a great ball this year.
I can hardly wait.
Remember last year those two ugly sisters came and wore those awful hats?
I remember.
Yes, I remember, Prince.
I don't know where he went to.
I remember.
All right.
My main idea that I'm back in Woodstock, besides to see Nancy, is to try and start a puppet company here. And since I know all the shows, and I've got all the music, and on each show there is the voice and music tape, which you heard part of one,
mm-hmm.
and then there's another tape which goes along and tells you what to be doing, you should be doing.
I don't know what we're going to do, Paige. Ever since the beautiful girl ran away, the prince has been sinking lower and lower. Hello, Prince. How are you feeling? I'm sinking lower and lower. See?
See?
Prince, I thought it might cheer you up a bit if we had some entertainment, so I brought someone along. Is it all right?
Yeah.
Yes. You may come up, little Margaret. Dance softly. The prince is very sad.
Thank you.
your enjoyment, we will be entertained by a world-renowned musician.
Here we go.
Will play for us.
God help me.
Oh, dear. He was living here for 3 years. And then
yeah, over 3 years. Mm-hmm. We'll just leave it like that.
Okay.
Goodbye, old house. I hope I never see you again.
Now the lights come down. And here comes Fred out of the closet.
Oh, Fred, I forgot. with me and live in the palace? Wonderful.
And so it was that Cinderella married the prince, and Fred went to live with Cinderella and the prince in the palace, and they all lived happily ever after.
I could let people know that I need a place to live.
Yes, you could.
Desperately. Nancy has she can't handle it. I used to be there, but not anymore. So if you can throw something that my way, that I'm looking for a place to live desperately.